me restart the emulator and give the 3 minutes back to Brigandine. Yeah, my bot is supposed to stop a host once I start streaming, but it doesn't always work. Pick the blue guys? Okay, Kami. Good looking out. I'll take his advice to heart. So I covered a whole bunch of ground there. I was talking about Xenoblade versus Xenogears versus Xenosaga for Leon, and I was talking about Kingkiller Chronicles, and I'm excited for that, and how Patrick Rothfuss is a smart dude. There's no way I could go back through all of like the last 6 minutes of me talking, so in lieu of that, I'll just move on. We're playing on uneasy. Blue guys. Those guys are kind of blue. They're very blue, but... and a lot of them are blue. Oh, maybe it's their nation color that's blue? There's two. There's a dark blue. Probably, I'm gonna guess, it's more of a purple. More of an indigo, right? Damn it, Marsted! Can't go going around destroying mini-malls whenever you want to save a girl's life. The Norns? Okay, got me. Dark blue is the best blue. 100% agree, Chaos. Alright, well, this cool parallax map scrolls. Xeno, the series, started with this company called Square, you should know about. You guys make Final Fantasy. They had an inside group of developers that eventually broke away from Square after making Xenogears and made a new company called Monolith Soft. They didn't own the rights to Xenogears, so they couldn't make a sequel to it. I'll let this cutscene play.
Even if war covers the world, even if all for Senna burns to ash, I will fight on like a demon. I will rule it all.
Oh man, fan translator voice actors. Flogaru in Norgard. Is it true, Gwyn? Is Amekus rebelled and destroyed Almechia? Almechia is another town we could have played as, I think. Yes, he's taken the title Emperor, founded a new country. I will rule it all! Utopia. Would starts in treason end in such a noble state? Zemeckis must be desperate to choose. Like, Robert Zemeckis? Only end with him ruling as a tyrant or dying a traitor. His name is Gwynglane. Success of his Utopia depends largely on him. Norgard surrenders peacefully, mission may come to pass. I ran about 5 minutes late because of the goofy hosting issue, so we'll pass that on to each of the games we switch to today. Time to unite Forsena. Now. First target is Juke's Castle. Yeah, right? I like Juke's as a name, too. Town of Dodges. Sister Esmeri is there. Esmeri. Thanks for... don't remind me. Let me remind the audience. My sister chose Zemeckis over me. I must fight her. Beanard. He just goes by Gwyn. That's good to know. Mentioning, I'm doing a lot of game switching on a lot of different platforms today with a new microphone, so if you guys need me to turn up or down the game volume, please give me a heads up. Hey, little DPs and Knight, how you guys doing? Mega Man?
So, Square Eye, to unify this continent and end this terrible age of war, Knights of Norgard, will you now follow me to this future?
Yes, my lord! I, your loyal servant, Palamedes, would jump through fire and water to follow you wherever you may choose to go. I am your weapon!
How predictable.
What?
Unlike you, His Majesty is a very prudent man. Why on earth would he ever need to jump through any fire or water?
Why, you?
This is what you kept me waiting for.
That was pretty outstanding. I guess the White Wolf is slow to get his act together. I guess I could try, like, talking the way they do. Ah, the lovely Princess Brangien, cheerful as ever.
If my father, King Eardwolf, were still alive, Norgard would already rule for Senna without needing to hide in the shadows for a year.
Huh, I must be incompetent.
Grr, stop patronizing me. That the throne went to you just because I'm a woman, unbearable.
Huh, I take it you will not support me in the coming war.
Did I say I wouldn't fight? Regardless of who is king, I am a knight of Norgard. I fight for Norgard without hesitation.
Like a holy maiden lighting the darkness. Your presence will strengthen our hearts 100-fold. Surely we shall deliver Forsenna into your fair hand.
So it is. Norgard go. This is different.
So it is. Norgard goes to war. Gwyn, Yvain, Palamedes, march on Juke's castle.
Yeah. Die, monster. You don't belong in this world.
Cannot the same be said of all religions?
It's time to show the world Norgard's power.
I should just do that in every game that doesn't have voice acting. Like, let's do the bad anime voice acting.
We have taken Juke's castle. That was quick. The enemy fled without a fight, so we took no casualties.
Do without a fight. Our choice, albeit a cowardly one. Oh man, organized phase. I don't know what that means. Let's do this. During organized phase, you can arrange troops, summon creatures, or move knights to prepare for combat. Move cursor to a castle with a fluttering flag and press circle to give commands. Don't forget to assign newly summoned creatures to a knight. Once you're done arranging a troop, move it to the front line using move. Battles occur at borders, so if a unit will be used in battle, move it to a border castle. Then you may send a rune knight exploring on a quest. A questing knight may discover items or meet new knights, but they are not available for battle. Done, press start and select execute. Move the new quest order to be carried out before the... Oh, that's interesting. So you send them all what you're doing, and then you hit execute, and everything happens temporaneously. Squire difficulty, you can select auto to let your advisors issue commands for you. If you're at a loss, this can be helpful. Oh, so you can just, like, auto-play the game? Alright, let's do organize. Oh my god, there's all this shit. This is, like, ogre battle for the first time. Let's look at them one by one. UI's pretty clean. I'm actually going to need, like, the sprite graphics as well. Baynard. Huggin. Huggin. Brookstorm. Wolf. It's Knocknog. We've got a lot of Norse naming styles here, which isn't surprising. I'm not screwing around with class at the moment. Curious to see, like, what equipment looks like. Okay, so it's like over battle. You can have one thing equipped per person. That's cool. Now, like, rename dudes? Knight can't be renamed. Oh, cool. Just demonstrating what you can do with this game. I didn't mean to do who Steve when I did remove the who, but there we go. I'll remember him better. It'll be more credible to me. Okay, dear. Hey, Cappy, how you doing, man? Yeah, let's summon some dudes, yeah? Ooh. Dude, I totally want to summon all of these things. Oh, and it costs mana to summon things. That's cool. Alright, okay. I got this. Let's do a Gigascorp. Is that like 1,000 scorps, or is it as big as 1,000 scorpions? I assume that means that it's just something that gets added to my organized list, right? Oh, that's okay. Okay, I get it. I understand. I like how the, like, quality of the sprites is wildly different. Like, these guys look way different than this guy. He looks almost like an NES character. Alright. Yeah, ogre battles later today. Oh, I can pop the other castles that I control and there's other dudes there. Nice. So I could do that all day. Any of the castles that have a blue flag on them. Shit. There's a lot of stuff I can do on my turn. These are the bad guys. I want to move dudes to them. Let's just try doing that. Move Gumblane forward. Yeah, I know, I want to fight them. Wait, so I'm basically just like moving, I'm deciding which troops go where, and then the fights are going to happen automatically. Like, I'm not sending someone to a certain place, I guess. Try doing quests, see how that works. Oh, you just send them on a quest and they go. Okay. So am I correct in understanding that, like, they just stay in their castles and I decide who's manning which castle at any given time? Maybe I have to move them if, like, this one falls to the enemy or something? Organized troops in the territory. Well, I'm not going to... I think that I'm happy with the way that it is to begin with, so... Don't even move anybody. Ah, okay. Gotcha, dear. Attack phase, you can order knights to attack an adjacent castle, but it's wise to check who is defending the castle first. Move the cursor to an enemy castle and push triangle to scout its defenders. It's unwise to attack stronger enemies. You decide to invade, choose attack. Okay. Cool. I can send one of these people to go scout, right? Okay. So there's like a level 29 Death Knight and a level 26 Shogun here, compared to my dudes who are not prepared to handle that. So we're not dorking around with Lydney here. They're trying to teach me, I think. Ornkey has a bunch of really huge dudes. How big are my dudes here? I guess I could have looked at these beforehand and moved people around. Yeah, that's not happening either. You guys aren't the strongest. Alright, that's possibly doable. What about new Elmekia? What's my, what's my objective? Is that visible to me? Yeah, so I have a bunch of super weak parties. This one I could potentially have taken if I had moved my units a little bit more cleverly, but I guess if I lose this fight, I can always try again after. And if the flag's not flapping, that means that there's no one there who can attack, that makes sense. Alright, well, this is the only one I think we have a chance of winning, so I'm gonna try doing that. Over the whole map, even with the huge dudes. I guess I must have some big characters that I'm just not aware of at the moment. Let's do this. Attack! These guys seem fine. They're the ones that I want to move out to the front, I guess, next time. Sure. And all of them to attack these guys. So I'm probably going to lose this battle. Because I didn't organize my troops. It's like, ah, okay, they're just cool people at the front. Now I know how to check how strong they are. Now, careful for next time. Let me make sure that this actually saved my attack settings. Okay. It did. The other castles, they're gonna get wrecked if I try to send them out, so I'm not gonna do that just yet. I could try sending these guys over, but they're also just gonna get wrecked. Alright, let's see what happens. Execute. Oh man. Garuda Castle. Okay, sure. Let's do our biggest guys first. Weak people can try to come in and mop up if we lose. We'll see what happens. I like having a separate map here. Mission is top priority. Reloader. Now you'll see the power of the three Abmechian, Almechian beauties. Am I one of the three? Of course. I like it. Three sisters united and fearless. Jesse, James. When did we become a sisterhood? Don't rain on our parade. It's just a figure of speech. Let's get him. I hope that there's like banter like this at all the castles we try to take. So these characters would have been in my party if I had played as Almechia, I take it. Yeah, this isn't what I was expecting at all. Ooh, hex grid. Look at that. So you can move further along the road, which is cool. Like, griffins have better movement, that makes sense. I don't know if I want to, like, be the one to attack or if defending is just as good. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Not soon enough. Hey, Nulu, you know Chan, how you guys doing? This dude has some kind of special power. Oh, they can either move or act, but not both. Interesting. I do really like the visual style of this game. And like having combat be like, okay, you make these really high level decisions on the big map, and then you slowly zoom in and do more and more as you play. The heads up, I'll mention this again later, but Matt is stopping by today during the stream. He just moved out to California. So it might be during like Xenosaga or something. I'm gonna run downstairs and let him in, and then he'll probably sit and kind of co-host. Matt so has stupido. Yeah, I like seeing both tactics and strategy. That's cool. This is a pretty rad game. Good on Sanguine for exposing me to it. How different is this version from the original? This is the Grand Edition, which was never formally released in the States, apparently. Oh, and you can retreat if you're on the edge of the map. That's cool. This guy's name is Stinky? All blast of cutting wind. Okay. Oh, he's a djinn. Got it. Different music. Yeah, I saw the multiplayer thing on the opening menu. That's interesting. Angel versus Centaur. Oh, interesting. Cool. So the actual battle is more like Final Fantasy Tactics than Ogre Battle. What's the elementals here? Does Griffin beat Scorpion? Ah, sure. So if they're named, maybe they have some kind of special ability. Magic. Or invoke runes to resist magic for a while. It's kind of cool, but that's. These cost things? Oh, pre-move only. So you have. So I would use this one if I had to move. I'm going to use this one because it's going to be against a person who's right next to me. And I'd use throw spear to hit someone who's far away. I get it. Yeah. Critical. Let's look at that. So much damage. Hey, thank you, D-Rock. Appreciate that. I don't have an alert set up for Patreon because there's no API. So yeah, if you subscribe on Patreon, give me a heads up, and I will thank you. Thank you very much. You should be set up. I'll send out a SP boost thingy for you. D-Rock is one of my OG followers. He's been here since Earthbound, the first game I played on stream. Oh, they all get names in the Grand Edition? Gotcha. Were the few monsters that had names, were they, like, particularly good, I'm guessing? I don't know if there's any benefit to have my units so close together like this. I did see the Patreon hack thing, yeah. Great timing too, right? no credit card data, but I guess they have like my phone number and stuff, which... Oh, I can hit my own units. Okay, well that's good to know. I wasn't sure if there was friendly fire. It turns out there is. Lesson learned. This is a lesson learning battle. Yeah, it wasn't severe. Gotcha. Yeah, they don't have any credit card PayPal info. I think they got encrypted passwords, so they recommend you change your password in case the encryption's ever broken, but the chance of that happening is pretty small, so... I mean, go ahead and change your password. It was yesterday or the day before, I think. It wasn't as severe as the Sony hack a while ago. Oh, I can stop him. That's good to know. How does this work? Okay, so that would hit A buddy. I want to send him, like, out into the group of enemies. I can stamina through some movements. Oh, and I can target from a distance. That's great. Now let's kill this angel. I do like the variety of abilities. This game suffers from the same issue that Ogre Battle has, that it really needs to gate the game to you a little bit more, I think. Like, giving you all these units and all the shit you can do on the very first battle of the game, I doubt they'd make a game like that today, you know? It's cool, like, I'll learn it, it's fun. But you could easily have a battle that just has, like, a single unit that has three really simple characters and slowly introduce you to what everybody does. Yeah, I'm excited for that coming. Because it's not a game breaker, it's just interesting to see how game design has evolved. Good games almost always will gate content, and back in the day they just didn't do that. Doesn't mean that you have to do that to have a good game. So does each individual unit have mana with which to summon new units? Or is a mana like a army-wide pool? Also, is there permadeath in this game? Try to poison things if I can. Not good. Looks like being on the attack isn't super important. It could be importanter. Monsters at permadeath? Gotcha. Oh, that's a cool distinction between, like, non-monsters. Cool, D-Rock. How did your... you had a rehearsal dinner yesterday, right? How'd it go? Vastly underleveled, so they probably have a good chance of avoiding it. Probably want to have people who are comparably leveled attacking her in the future. I could see like a single battle, like the map that we're on that has all those castles. We're probably talking like 4 hours or something. Like it would be a really long time to clear all the castles, right? Unless if you have super OP units, maybe. Which is cool, like it's neat when you have a game that's set up like that. But... has to move. Looks like it doesn't give him an attack option unless if he's close enough to attack. I'm guessing he can't shoot over somebody's head. Maybe he can. Can't counter him too far away. Let's stand in melee range with an archer next time. Oh, cool, dear. Let's see what this special ability is. I'll cry. Get you a brain curdling scream. Stuns for... Oh, and it says friend and foe, so you know right away whether it gets both or not. Level 1 versus level 11. Oh, that's nice. It looks like there's not this giant, like, accuracy penalty for your level being of sorts. Or level seems less important in this game than it is in a lot of other titles. Alright, come in stinky. I've always come in stinky. Right on, D-Rock. Earn 3. Good that, I was saying in the, like, 7 minutes before I realized that the stream wasn't coming up, I'm pretty excited about the Painkiller Chronicles TV show plus movie deal. Like, Patrick Rothfuss really has the spark. If you read his blog post about it, he's very self-aware and talks about how, like, you know, can we just be excited about this for now? I know that there's going to be time to worry soon enough and think that they're going to molest my books, but no one's more concerned about that than I am. He's like, people are saying, oh, they're doing a TV deal before the book series is done, but in truth, the third book is done. Like, there's a completed manuscript. He's just an aggressive editor, which is very, very different from the situation we have with George R.R. Martin and A Song of Ice and Fire, where we have no idea how many chapters of his next book are done. It could be 10. Hey, Kylie, how you doing? Great stream last night with Overboard. Hung out for a while. Dag and Brawly are delightful people. Later, girl. Now, what happens to her associated monsters? Look at that. Helix getting mad levels. So I guess it's good to have a low-level unit kill a high-level unit. And try to hit as many people as we can. Also has this airstorm ability. This is a channel that I hosted last night. They're partnered streamers, they're a duo. Just throw them a follow if you haven't already. It's twitch.tv/overboardgaming. Overboard, B-O-R-E-D, not B-O-A-R-D. Let's go here. Yeah, looks like they can attack maybe the... I think that the enemies can body block each other, but allies don't body block for ranged attacks. Making that up, I don't know if that's true. But, ouch. That wasn't the worst. Point blank. There's a really cool book called The Etymologicon. It's about etymologies for words, and it's written in this very, like, stream of consciousness style. So he talks about how the etymology for the word biscuit will take him into the etymology for the word bisexual, because the bi at the beginning is the same bi. So then he'll go from talking about biscuits for a page, and then he'll start talking about the word bisexual, and then he'll go on to something else. It goes on and on like that for the whole book. It's very well written. And that was related to one of the words that just came up, and then I forgot what word it was, so... I'm sure I'll mention Etymologicon again in the future. Come back to me. Oh, I'm sorry, Broken One. Any luck with watching on YouTube with the quality options there? I believe it's that the end of the word biscuit means baked. So it literally means twice baked or twice cooked or something like that. Ooh, we have a pretty good chance to hit a bunch of dudes here. Although, if I stay put, I like that there's a real decision between moving and attacking without moving. That's pretty cool. A lot of these kind of SRPGs take for granted that you can always move and attack, and it's nice to have to make a choice. Still be able to do both, but get advantages as we stay put. Makes for more interesting units. It's kind of a cool game design. Broken One, if you're unable to tune in for Rocket Knight, you can try watching on YouTube later. If there's any new folks in chat, I am multi-streaming to YouTube and Hitbox at the same time until I get a partnership. So if you have buffering issues on Twitch, since I don't have the little quality options, you can try watching on YouTube where those quality options are provided for free. It seems cool that casters have these big, like, they call it PB AoEs, point-blank AoEs around them. So you want to, you almost want to send your casters out in the middle of a bunch of enemies without your allies near them. But that's super dangerous. Yeah, so like I said, really cool design space in this game. 4 health from dead. Blue urns. Design space is really cool to think about. It's neat how you can have just a really simple mechanics change. Like, let's decide that there are things you can do without moving that you can't do if you move, and like how much room that gives you to grow the units in different ways. It seems like that's really simple on its face at the beginning, a simple difference between like Final Fantasy Tactics and this title. But it has some pretty huge implications. What is a special dude? It's friend and foe, right? So I don't want to use that. Maybe if I move somewhere more aggressive where I don't have allied units nearby. Usually caster PBOE don't have friendly fire? Okay, that's good to know, Peter. And it specifies that at the bottom of the screen, right? It says, like, friend and foe or something like that. So I can get this dude over here, and then he can shoot hunter shots. I'll be thinking I'm already hosed from not using the organized phase smartly, because like this is a long battle to go into if I'm just going to game over after this because I didn't move my strong units to the front lines. Here I should be able to use the Polar Storm special. Ah, if the hex is highlighted, it hits that creature. Gotcha. I think there's like a turn limit when you're not playing on easy, right? I thought it said that when I picked my character at the beginning. So she can't get to attack me, right? She may as well just cast Ward. Resist magic. I don't know who I'd pick. I still want to do it on one of my pyromancer. Let's do that. This whole time to move people next turn. So am I the only one initiating battles and invading, or is there like an enemy phase where they pop into my maps? Like, did you get bonus XP for inflicting death? Alright. Can I hit two dudes at the same time with the genie fart magic? No, I guess not. I must be out of MP or something. That's funny. Later, friend. Gallop is level 3, level 5. Killing higher level mobs is pretty strong. But maybe they won't this early in the game. Treat. Oh, pretty cool. I can still pick off. Oh, okay, we just wait until they retreat, sure. Everyone gets XP. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I like this game. This is pretty sweet. I read this really, like, nasty IGN review about it. Oh, and then we capture whoever doesn't run away. That's really cool. It's like, man... They mentioned at TwitchCon that, like, they used to be afraid of gaming journalists, like, how they would react to a game, and now it's like, big broadcasters. have sort of replaced that, playing their game in early access or right when it launches. Leonia's Queen. Their days of hiding in tranquil prayer are over.
I don't see the benefit in making more enemies.
Ah, so you think that Leonia will choose to resist?
Leonia has long been fiercely independent. I don't think it will yield easily.
Perhaps. That is why I want to assess their queen.
That's why I want to asses their queen. Not the best fan translation.
She may wish to protect Leonia, but does she have the resolve to back it up?
My lord.
One day, Leonia may become our greatest enemy. It is wise to know your enemy.
If that is your choice, I will not question. Safe travels.
Farewell.
I get the sense that Vaynard says a lot.
Castle Damas.
So at last we finally meet. I am the king of Norgard, Vaynard.
I am Lioness, queen of Leonia.
Did they need to voice act that?
I will get straight to the point. You have two choices. Leonia can swear allegiance to Norgard and become a vassal state, or there will be war. Choose. What? I ought to. As I expected, Lady Lioness.
King Vaynard, Leonia has always been recognized as a free state, even at the height of Almechia's power. I'm sorry, but we cannot give up our independence.
Very well. War it is.
Wait, please. We do not wish to fight. Leonia would never attack Norgard. Can't you just leave us in peace?
The decision was yours. If you cannot live with your choices, you are unfit to rule. Leonia is already mine.
Dude, I like the Nords.
But do you want just want an excuse to fight?
Leonia will not submit. It must be taken by force.
You leave us no choice. You will have your war. But know this, I will never forgive you for dragging the people of Leonia into this.
So it is. Leonia cannot bury its head and hide in this age of war. I will add, though, your words are bold. Your body trembles.
Oh, though your words are bold. But it's bad voice acting that we're trying to do.
You should stop that. It betrays you. Farewell. We will meet again, Lioness. In battle, ha ha ha.
We will meet again. In battle, ha ha ha. Energy from the Weidar Womb, Mega Man. We find that Meteor. We'll find Dr. Wowie.
Soul of a saint, yet also the determination to fight. Ha ha ha. You may be a tough opponent after all.
Your Majesty, Lin Tail is here to see you.
Interesting. Show him in.
Another cutscene?
Your Majesty, thank you for seeing me.
Luntail, it's been a while. As I recall, you left Norgard, claiming you was too young to be any king. What is your business here?
Well, I came to congratulate you on your recent victory. I'm sure late King Airwolf will be pleased.
You did not come here to congratulate me. I expect you wish to review my competency as Norgard's king in light of recent victories.
What? My lord, I would not presume.
So what sort of man do you see before you now?
Ah!
I don't know how to read, like, two exclamation points.
I humbly profess, I see a man fit to be king.
Now you wish to work for this king again?
Like, it was went in order of, like, one, two, and three exclamation points.
Vaynard, my lord and king, I beg your forgiveness. I misjudged your ability and did not give you the credit you were due. Please allow me to rejoin your service. I am unworthy and will gladly serve in the lowest position.
No need. The position has already been prepared for your return.
All right. What's up, Kami? All right, let's move people around. I was like, I should read the text, but we should do it like the bad voice actors. Oh wow, yeah, we do have some pretty buff dudes. They're not as buff as the purple map people, though. Very good. Alright, so let's see if there are any maps that have big, like, units in it. Does he get, like, a different map or something, Peter? Oh, right, you mean up here. I see what you're saying. Now he's, like, all by himself.
Sure.
So I need to do, like, the summon command. Hold on. Circle. Summon. Spend all my mana, but it sounds like we share mana and we generate it each turn, right? Is the little circle there, is that how many that I've summoned right now? Or does that, like, indicate a... What's a little circle where it says to the left of dragon, wyvern, giant, lizard man, all that stuff? Human dragon, why not? You have a maximum of that many creatures. I must be like an element or something, right? Because I summoned a wyvern and the circle didn't fill in. Elemental affinity, okay. So like the dragon's fire, the wyvern doesn't have one. The lizard man is water. Hey Frappuccino, how you doing? Do I move him where I want him to go? Press some other buttons to figure it out here. Hold on. You have unlimited, or I guess you're just limited by your mana. Well, I probably have to do it via the organized command. Right now I'm just pressing triangle. Yeah. I was just looking at like who's in there. Okay, got it now. You can, like, move the units around, go to the same castle, sub them out. Makes sense. So what's this value down here where it says 215 out of 225 that was going up as I was adding units? Is that, like, limited by the leader's charisma or something like that? They can only have so many units in their party of certain strength, so you can't make some crazy OP unit? I'm gonna see if I see a value that makes sense. Make sure everybody has a full unit. Oh, I'm sorry, Fraff. I know that feel. My feet get like really, really sore really quickly. I have to be kind of careful. Can I use summon from here now? I'm gonna spend less mana this time. Make a squirt, make a merman. Looks like I can cut through this pretty quickly. I like the idea of like binding monsters to your service. Oh, that's interesting. So why do these guys have different monsters that they're able to summon? That depend on like the what drives which monsters each unit is able to summon. I guess summarize my question. So now I'm in excess of my rune bar. Oh, I see. So it's associated with a castle, not with a unit that's currently there. Interesting. Right, I see the rune power now. They're at the top. You see rune 201, and then I can only have 201 points of units in my party. Alright. Well, these guys don't need to be chilling back here. I can move them. We should be able to take the other castle that's nearby there without too much trouble. Oh, seriously, Frapp? No kidding. I had no idea that that was even a shortcut. These guys do it, or what's the deal with these dudes? I don't really lose too many of my dudes. There's a lot of guys at this castle, so... Is it a maximum of 3 units that fight each other at a time? Like, or am I going to be going up against all 6 of these people if I try to attack there? Yeah, the little, like, digging shortcut that just takes you all the way through the tunnel for Aff. Is, I think I know the one you're talking about, when you're Wolf Link in Twilight Princess? I had no idea. Okay, so the computer will probably pick 3. What if I defeat their castle, and they had other units there that didn't participate in the fight? Do they just, like, retreat to a different castle or something? How does retreating work? I might go ahead and just send these people over, since this team just got a bunch of level-ups and stuff. They're not, like, amazing, but we saw that level's not that important to determine whether you can be successful. They get bumped back to, like, the next castle behind them, I guess. Where? Let me make sure... I've got room for some new units here. We captured this chick, so we'll bring her in here. Now it's like mana is shared across all groups. This castle is able to summon pixies, and we know that because we captured it, and when we were fighting before, it just had a bunch of pixies in it. Save. So we're playing Brigandine in another 15 minutes or so. I ran over, we had some issues with the host still running before stream started, so we lost about 5 minutes of playtime. So we'll play until 1:05 Pacific, and then we'll start up Rocket Knight Adventures from 1:05 to 2:05. 2:05 to 3:05 is Xenosaga, and after Xenosaga we're doing Secret of Monkey Island and Ogre Battle. I think I'm okay with this. Let's execute. And save during combat. That's good to know. Thanks, Dieter. Because, yeah, it does seem like you're expected to fight for a really long time, right? Oh, interesting. So I've started them moving, but they're not actually here yet. I see. Takes a while for you to organize. Probably by the next turn, I'm guessing. It sounds like you want to check that makes sense. Oh yeah, so this area is not as anywhere near as nasty as it was before. Two units here. How strong are they, though? Dupes. Oh, it's doable. I mean, it's 2 versus 3 units. That might be what gets us hose. I'm not gonna tempt fate. Oh, interesting. Okay, they can defend but can't attack yet. Makes sense. Attack the next one. Camel Ford. Interesting. That's cool, Dieter. So you can, like, try to play around that by intentionally putting weak units next to the tougher people to get the big guys move out of the way. Unicorn army. I do like that you don't have to kill their monsters, you're just trying to take out their commanders. Thank you. Let's move everybody as close as we can. You think I was making an error in the last battle of, like, keeping all my units super closely packed together? Imagine that could be a problem if there's an enemy, like, mage or something that can do a big area attack. I don't know if it lends... If there's, like, hidden modifiers that say, hey, if you have allies next to you, that gives you a benefit in battle. It seems to be pretty common in games like this. Dillard is a grappler. Get a bunch of monster buddies. This game feels pretty well polished too for a PS1 title. It could just be a big chunk of that might be because it's a big chunk of that might be because it's a remake. I hear it's a re-release of the original Brigandine game, so they had some more time to polish it, but like it has pretty clear mechanics. Good presentation, what you're doing. Women's are really hard to do. I see. So far, I've been the one doing all the aggression. Does that remain true, or is later in the game the enemy gets more aggressive and tries to attack me? Next round, I think. Okay, gotcha. So the different modes determine... It seems like if you're playing an easy mode, you're saying, I have full control over what's going on the battlefield. I kind of like that, though, that they offer that as an option. We take out this Jhin here. So the Jhin doesn't get to counterattack. Maybe it's only a melee range thing and can't counterattack. Plus shooter. Maybe it's like one of its disadvantages because it can typically attack two units at a time. Rising Squad. I couldn't tell what the wizard did to upgrade that one flying enemy. The fact that it's like glowing green now. It has some kind of buff on it, obviously. Just counter. Oh, because it has no natural attack, which is what keeps it from countering, I see. So it has to have a natural attack to even be able to counter in the first place. We have an undead ghoul named Flower. Let's counter. Guard Squad. We can get close enough to anybody. Hit some of the monsters. It's... Well, can't quite get anyone. That's just too bad. Looks like there's, you know, forest tiles. You can have certain characters that are particularly good in the forest. Centaurs, I'd imagine, sylphs. Ooh, he was stunned. That's cool. Oh, and he gets to... That's cool. He gets to take a step at the end of his attack. That's pretty awesome. That reminds me of Dungeons & Dragons. There's a lot of powers in 4th edition that let you do things like that. And he can't counter because he's stunned. And he's poisonous. take a look at the dragon. He's got a special acid breath. Friend and foe. Terror jaw. I think I can get the. Looks like the Hydra has really slow move speed, but I'm guessing when I get in range, they're pretty good. Squat. Do anything just yet? I totally can. We could try to go hit. I think you're focusing on the commanders here. Miss. That's not good. You don't want your... As easy it is to resummon your units, you don't want to have to, looks like, because you put a lot of investment into giving them experience and leveling them up. When you summon them, they start at level 1. Even though the level is not super critical, you can still be competitive as a level 1 creature versus a level 12 creature. You have some investment in your monster units. Better in water, I bet you. I can get to anybody right now. Harden. Raise defense for a while. Oh, it has like a silence ability too, that's cool. Let's see what happens now. Oh. And poison damage. Okay, the poison ticks at the start of the turn proper. We're playing about for about 5 more minutes to give time back to this title, and then we're switching over to Rocket Pet Adventures, which is a Broken One subgame. Cool abilities. Squeak Unicorn. Aw, goodbye, Unicorn. So ends the tale of Squeak. So that was good placement on the Jin's part. Nice to be able to hit two units on a turn, usually without much risk of hitting your own party members if you're smart about it. So anyone that's highlighted getting hit. So this doesn't hit all the enemies, that's pretty good. Or at least I think it means that I'm able to hit all of them, so I can't actually. That's good. Well, I still have to. I just have to pick somebody. But it still hit everybody. That's pretty strong, man. Yeah, that was pretty awesome. I hit just about every enemy unit on the board. I imagine I'm pretty limited in how often I can do that, too. Took out a Jin. Hey, Flarewing, how you doing? Wizard Man. Hagen, let's just go ahead and attack. Lefty Axe. Fair enough. Oh, just short. But I shouldn't attack that bird again, because the poison tick is going to kill him on his next turn. Oh wow. That guy's really good defense. Goodbye, Ghoul. The Noxville burned him. First in the underworld. I don't know what that does. Find out. Oh wow, just does a bunch of damage. Okay, that's cool too. Take it. It may also have some other component that I didn't pick up there. Poison might never kill. Alright. I'll give it a try. I won't attack the thing just in case. I guess if it attacks somebody, they're gonna die. I see. Holy is like a, maybe like a white or a yellow symbol underneath their unit status. Is that right? I'm healing monks, man. My monk can't heal it just yet. Once we get back to our turn, I'll go ahead and save and we'll start up Rocket Knight Adventures. Save, look at that. Mid-battle save. And I'll make it on a separate slot since it's in the middle of a fight, but I'm sure I'm just going to load the most recent one. Oh, well, we'll just do this one. Remove memory card? Not! Alright, cool. So that was Brigandine. Sanguine Haze, as you watch in the future on... YouTube, good choice. I enjoyed that. I had no idea what I was in for. I had some expectations. I was thinking this is going to be a not so awesome SRPG because it's on the PS1 and PS1 games tend not to age well. But I think that that actually has aged quite well. Goofy cutscenes with like band translator voice actors aside. So let's switch over to Rocket Knight Adventures. Give me